a delightful breeze, and a breathtaking view. What is it like in the future? Is the world still a beautiful place? I swear I could hear the glimmer in your eyes and the adoration in your voice. While we wait, will you not tell me about your adventures? Well, not the portentous events which led you here, but the simple delights all your own. By learning about the future world, I may gain insight into future me's plans. But more than that, I have an interest simply as a fellow traveler. Short of going somewhere oneself, there's naught more stirring than hearing another's account. Incredible. Would that I could have been there to see it. Yours is a harsh and unforgiving world. Yet in spite of this, your brethren hold fast to their virtue. To know that the light of mankind's potential still shines, even in that faraway place, it gives me heart. Thank you for regaling me with your tales. I will treasure every word. As you know, I was once a scholar. And among other things, I sought to understand the workings of the world. What exactly is Aether? How formed the laws of nature? Whence sprung mankind? Riddles and mysteries beyond counting. Over the years, I have managed to find answers to some few of them. Yet rather than attain a sense of mastery, the more I understood, the more I came to hold the world and its miracles in awe. We too are miracles, each and every one of us, born of the warm breath of life that traverses the heavens, swirling through eternity. When I fully grasped the improbability of our existence, nothing felt impossible anymore. If it could be imagined, it could be done. A passion swelled within me, an epiphany dispelling all preconceptions of what was natural and true, and a presence without, immense yet intimate. Fate, perhaps, holding us in its tender embrace. As reassuring as it was intimidating, how keenly aware I became of creation's fragility, built as it is upon precarious happenstance. I was overcome with an irrepressible urge to know the world more intimately, to hear its voice, feel its breath. I ventured forth on a journey that very day, so very long ago now. freed from presumption and prejudice. I saw the world through a newborn's eyes. Everything fresh and new. And so, so beautiful. Lands that stretched on forever. Skies one could drown in. The heartbeat of nature, silent yet strong. And amidst it all, a people. Beacons of light and life. Laughter that warmed my heart like naught else before. They are my meaning, and my purpose, my love. And so long as they need help, I cannot return to the star. Perhaps my future self is still waiting for it. A moment she can let go and walk unto the end. Safe in the knowledge that man will find his own way. You, who are our future, tell me this, and tell me true. Has your journey been good? Has it been worthwhile?
Forgive my lateness. My observation subject was rather irritable, and it took a while to settle it down.
No need to apologize. Your work takes precedence. Besides, we had a pleasant conversation in the meantime.
You're too kind. Now then, I'm told you wished to ask me some questions.
Indeed. I've an interest in one of Hermes's creations, Meteon. You witnessed a host of them take flight, yes?
Oh, that! Yes, yes, I did. 'Twas in the dark of the morn. I'd left the Thalassi after nocturnal observation. As I walked along, I spied a bright light climbing high into the southeastern skies. Then, in an instant, it was gone. Like a shooting star, only rising rather than falling. But then another shot up, then another, and another. Intrigued, I made my way to the edge to investigate. And who should I spy on an isle to the south but Hermes and Meteon, the Metea, rather. There were lots of them, and I realized they must be the shooting stars that I'd seen.
A dazzling spectacle indeed. Have you spoken with Hermes about this?
Oh, yes. The sight left such an impression on me that I approached him about his mystery project the very next day. Alas, he said that he couldn't reveal anything just yet, that he needed to conduct further tests. It shouldn't be long now, though. He often returns to that isle, and I have a feeling he's nearing a breakthrough.
Splendid. We are likewise eager for the details. Well, that is all we wish to ask. Thank you for taking the time to indulge our curiosity.
You're very welcome. It's always a pleasure to speak with other inquisitive souls. Oh, and will you be descending now? If so, I shall link the doors for you.
Please.
Let neither side hold back. blade sings! Try something different. No quarter. You won't be easily overcome, but neither will I. Only just begun. Come at me with your all. Very well. Let us move to the final trial. accept your burdens and show me your strength of will!
You still stand. The people of your time are more resilient than I had dared hope. I have seen enough. It was my intent to finish it, but clearly I underestimated you. One would think I never learn. I made the same mistake with Azim when we first sparred. Despite being less than half my age, his strength was astounding. As is yours. 'Tis plain you have weathered considerable hardship. Far more even than your tales would suggest. It seems we have both learned much on our journeys. Well now. I dare say he has warmed to you. A boon to be sure. He never forgets his favorites, and is ever eager to come to their aid. Quite a small place, lacking even the most basic equipment. The present may yield no clues, but we may yet try perusing the past. Have you done this before? So you cannot control the power freely. Worry not. I shall assist you. Come and stand before me. There are two ways to see the past. The first entails peering through the walls of the soul in the moment a subject is recalling a memory. The second requires no subject, and is instead a process of piecing together an event from ripples left in the ambient ether. As memories are etched upon the ether of the soul, so too are they etched upon the ether of the world. In this way can history be preserved. Such memories are given to fading, however, and can prove challenging to visit. But come, let us try. Close your eyes.
All units fully functional and proceeding on course towards their respective stars. Estimated time to completion of survey is 108 cycles. End of status report. Severing connection with shared consciousness.
Did you hear that, Hermes? All is well.
Yes. Good tidings at long last. Every step of the way, I've been reminded how little we understand creation. How the universe defies imagination.
But soon we won't need to speculate. We'll know the answers. What others live for.
Indeed. And we'll owe it all to you and your sisters.
I wonder what answers we will get.
Whatever intelligent beings that exist out there are bound to be vastly different from us. Diverse in form and culture, possessed of unique ways of thinking. Their conception of life and its purpose will be no exception. Completely and utterly unlike ours.
Utterly unlike? How?
I have no idea. Yet whatever answers we receive, I will not dismiss them out of hand. No, I will think earnestly on them all. And I will share them with our people, that together we may contemplate our own existence. Perhaps then our star will become a better place. Not only for man, but for all life. Meteon, though I gave you wings to soar the heavens, I did not teach you how to walk the earth. So loath was I to bind another living being. In the course of your long journey, you will learn from those you meet, learn to walk and run and so much more. And when you return, older and wiser, we will have a celebration to mark your homecoming and coming of age both.
Will there be apples covered in syrup?
And how are you supposed to eat them? Rather than food, perhaps... a flower. Yes. Upon your return, I will gift you a beautiful flower.
So, what is your opinion? I understand. He is a gentle soul, and well-intentioned. Yet it does not take ill intent to beget ill. We must consider the possibility that something may have gone awry. Perhaps it was oversight, or simply an accident. In light of this, I propose that we reveal your tale to Hermes himself. If he does not wish for the final days, as we believe, he may well join us in pursuing a solution. Then it is settled. Let us seek out our friend with all swiftness. 'Twould not do to let such a pure soul be blackened by tragedy.
Yeah.